Testing 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Test 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Boy, that's low. Test 1, test 2. Test 1, there we go. Test 2, test 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Test 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Test 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Testing 1. Testing 2. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Thank you. from the campus of Alabama State University, welcome to coverage of Hornets basketball here at Dunn Oliver Acadome. Today, it's the Lady Jaguars of Southern with a record of 9-12, 6-4 in conference play, taking on the home standing Lady Hornets of Alabama State. Same record, 9-12, 6-4 in SWAC action. Hi, everybody. I'm Graham Dunn. We got a doubleheader tonight and an important game for both the men and the women, trying to line up for their positioning in the SWAC tournament, which is now less than a month away. And tonight is a very important game. These two teams, the women's teams, come in tied for fourth place with that 6-4 record. Alabama State losing its first home game of the year on Saturday, dropping one to Grambling State on a last-second miss. In fact, there were a couple of last-second shots that went down for both teams, and eventually it was Grambling winning that one in the last seconds. We're going to take it to our public address announcer. We'll have our national anthem, and then you'll meet the starting lineup for tonight's game. Starters for Alabama State. We heard the Jaguars and they're starting five, and in just a second we'll hear who will start for the Lady Hornets in this key game here this afternoon.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the starters for you, Alabama State Lady Hornets! Freshman from Hazel Green, Alabama.
So your starting lineup, the normal starting lineup for Alabama State, Emmanuel, Crawford, Steele, Harris, and Ward. For head coach Freena Freeman Jackson, in her 25th year as the head coach at Alabama State, assisted by Clayton Harris, Courtney Stevens, and Yvette McDaniel. For the Southern Lady Jaguars, they'll start Taylor Williams and Chloe Fleming at the guards. Imani McQuain will also start at a third guard, a swing player. Genevieve Johnson is starting at forward. She wears number 25, and Raven White, a forward, wearing number 44. Again, the Jaguars come into this game having lost at Alabama A&M over the weekend, 60-50. They've lost two straight games. And both of these teams trying to get a foothold as far as the SWAC standings are concerned. Everybody's chasing Jackson State right now with a 9-1 record in conference play. Alabama A&M and Bethune-Cookman stand at 7-3 going into tonight's games. Meanwhile, Southern is tied with Prairie View and Alabama State and Arkansas Pine Bluff all in a tie for fourth. We're ready to go. Your officials tonight, Kristen Bell, Neonta Williams, and Marcus Smooth. ASU in the pink, a pink out tonight here at the Acadome. Dumped inside, knocked away in a turnover is how we'll start this one. Southern running. And an easy layup, and the first 2 points go to Southern as Johnson is good on the lay-in on the right side. Still working near side. Dumps it toward at the foul line, kicking out. Three is in the air, it's too strong. And Southern will take it the other way. Just underway here. At the Acadome, there's a shot no good. Underneath, we'll have a foul. It may go on Alabama State, and I believe it will. They're going to call it on Harris.
Foul on the shot. Foul towards the late points, number 20, Courtney Jackson.
So Harris picks up the first foul of the game. And they're going to say it's a shooting foul. That'll allow Taylor Williams to step to the free throw line. She only averages 3 points a game. This Jaguar squad does not have a lot of big-time scorers. And to be honest, they're not a great free throw shooting team either. In fact, Williams is just a 44% shooter. She does make the first. And she'll try again and make it. So the first 4 points scored by Southern here in this one. 4-0. Steele beats the pressure down court. Crawford as they work it left side now. Pull up inside the three-point arc. That one's no good. Rebound Southern. Slow start for the Hornets. Missing their first two shots. Inside and in trouble is Fleming. Kicks it back out. The three's in the air and it's too strong. Emmanuel has the rebound for Alabama State. Moving it the other way quickly. Ward driving. Inside it goes to Harris. Kicks it out. And the shot off the glass too strong. Southern the other way with a 4-point lead. Driving in the lane again. That one's blocked, and we get a traveling violation against the Jaguars. First turnover against Southern. Hornets looking for their first point of the game. We've played 2 minutes. Man-to-man defense set up by the Jaguars. Eight on the shot clock. It's five on the shot clock. Emmanuel looking for help. Needs to throw one up in a hurry, and I don't think they got it off. But it's too bad because the three was good by Steele. Just couldn't quite get it out of her fingers. And it gives it back to Alabama State, or excuse me, to Southern. A couple of turnovers early for Alabama State. So far, they've been shut out. Genovia Johnson off the glass, a pretty shot for her to first or make it second two of the game. She's got a couple of field goals. There's a steal in backcourt. Williams, no. Rebound, ASU, as Dekiah Sanders has it. Steele will try a strong shot, no good. Rebound, Southern. Shot is blocked. Baseball pass. Crawford trying to beat the defense, instead pulls it out. And then just lost it out of bounds. It's been that start, kind of a start so far for ASU. Somebody behind me just said, settle down. I agree. Four nothing early. We've played just under 3.5 minutes of this one. There's a walk. I'll give it back to ASU. Ryan Tillis in the game for the Hornets. Sanders to Emmanuel on the near side. Driving, picks up a triple team, throws one up, no good. But apparently we're going to get a foul on Southern. Goes against Tanisha Metcalf. Her first. And I believe that is the first foul against Southern in the game. First free throw is good by Emmanuel, averaging 16 points. An 81% free throw shooter. And she's good on both of those to get ASU on the board. It's 6-2. Moderate pressure by the Hornets in backcourt. Metcalf goes to her right and drives into the lane. Barely got defended, but missed the shot. Sanders the other way. Emmanuel trying to check the defender, can't do it. Gets a pick. Instead, it goes to Sanders. She wants one. Ward obliges, but she dribbles past it, nearly throwing it away, and that's a walk on Sanders. So the turnovers continue here for Alabama State, and they've managed just 2 points in the first 4 minutes of this one. Serviva Legions in the game for the Lady Jaguars. She is a freshman out of Brooklyn, New York. Metcalf. There's a heck of a, I was going to say, that's a heck of a screen set by Raven White. A little too much of a screen, and she'll get called for the foul. Southern football coaches would have loved that one. So the ball back to Alabama State. Dump a pass inside and a push from behind. And that's going to go against Zylies Harrison. I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. Harrison with a first foul on her. She's out of Garland, Texas. Still looking for their second bucket inside. No good. Rebound knocked out of bounds by Southern, I believe. Harrison touched it last. Good look inside. Just didn't get it to go. Been that kind of a start for the Hornets. Trying to look inside, but Ward is covered. Now floating into the lane, and a nice roll for Emmanuel. She has all four of ASU's points, and they cut the lead to 2 for the Jaguars. We've played roughly half of this first period. McWayne driving and lost it. Picked away by Tillis. Sanders. Emmanuel driving. Good. Right now it's the Ayanna Emmanuel show for ASU. She's got all 6 points. And we are tied. First time we've said that tonight. McWayne. Doubled up, has to get rid of it. Legions driving, pushes off, and doesn't get away with it. I thought for a second she might. But she gave an elbow, I believe, to Crawford. And that is the first foul on McWayne. And the fourth team foul on Southern. We've got a timeout on the floor. We're all knotted at 6 apiece. Stay tuned for more here on the Hornet Sports Network.
The biggest offer will award $33 to Hornet Athletics for every three-pointer made during today's game.
Left to play first period, 6-6 our score here at the Yakado. Neither team able to get a stronghold on their offensive play, and there's another turnover. That's been the problem for both teams so far. That is now 5 turnovers against the Lady Hornets. Southern has 3. And right now they're shooting just a little bit better than the Hornets. Driving and will get a pushing foul. They'll go, I believe. They're going to call it on Ashley Gray, who just entered the ball game. Gray, the freshman out of Washington County, Georgia. They throw it way in backcourt, does Southern. Diamond Hunter with it. Driving, Reed, shot, good. Shania Reed with the first bucket of the day. 8-6, Southern with the lead. Dump pass inside, and we got a pushing foul underneath. Going to go on the Jags. Sonya Reed picks up the foul, and that should be a free throw opportunity for Cordasia Harris.
Cordasia Harris at the line, shooting 2.
Harris came into the game averaging 9 points. And misses the first free throw.
One shot.
67% free throw shooter on the year. Junior out of Mobile, misses both. Rebound controlled by Southern, and they go the other way. Metcalf in a hurry, and she turns it over. Turnover number 4 against the Jaguars. Shamiya Ward back for Alabama State. 8-6 our score, 3.5 to play, first quarter. Dump pass inside, a good one. Ward looking to spin and lost it. And then she'll pick up a silly foul in back court, and that'll be her first. Should be the third team foul on Alabama State. Guy Sanders back in the game for the Hornets. She is guarding Fleming. Pair of fours there. As the three is up, three is no good. Rebound controlled by Alabama State. Quick outlet pass, there goes Sanders. Cross court, lost the basketball. Set him the other way. ASU is back defensively. Dump pass inside, and a foul, a good one, quite frankly. They called on Steele, I believe. She would not allow Harrison to get to the glass. First foul on Steele. And I believe that's Harrison at the line to shoot a pair. Harrison hadn't been to the free throw line much this year. She missed the first. She'll have another. Try to add to the lead here, and she does. First point of the game for her. And it's a three-point advantage for Southern. Sanders, pass. Emmanuel, hit as she goes up. She'll get free throws. Sonia Reed is guilty of her second. And Anaya Emanuel go back to the line. She's already made a pair all in this first quarter. She has all 6 points for Alabama State. And one more. One more for the senior from Fort Lauderdale, but that one no good. Rebound to the Jaguar. Fleming kicks it outside the arc. Shot is no good by Hunter. Ball is loose, picked up by the Hornets. Sanders gets the outlet pass, double teamed in backcourt, gets it to Emmanuel. In the corner, three in the air, good! Jayla Crawford. First bucket for her, first three for Alabama State. And the lead for the Hornets, they're also their first, 10-9. There's a three on their other end, it's too strong. Rebound, Hornets, Crawford. Crawford has it again. Emmanuel driving baseline, has it blocked nicely by Harrison. She leads the team in that category, and there's a walk on the other end. Hunter forgot to dribble as she headed down court. Another turnover, number four, I believe, against Southern. Handful of substitutions. Christian Jackson is in for Alabama State. She wears number 12. Minute 26 left, first quarter. 1 point lead for homestanding ASU. Kick out, and the return pass to Crawford. They're gonna get her for an offensive foul, they are. Crawford was a step late on that move. And that allowed Williams to take the charge. First foul on Crawford. And that is five now against Alabama State in the quarter. So should there be another foul on the floor, Southern will get free throws. Driving in the lane, and that one's blocked, but they're going to get a foul. They may get Harris. Way back up, they call it on Jackson. And That is her first. Emmanuel didn't get much of a break. She's back in the game. She replaces Sanders. Chloe Fleming is at the line awaiting her free throw opportunity. She is a 56% free throw shooter. And that percentage will dip a little bit after that one. Kind of an odd setup at the line. She's got 1 foot directly behind her. Missed the free throw, and now we've got a ball loose, and apparently ASU knocked it out of bounds. Jackson thought she had it. Instead, the Jaguars will have it under their basket. Johnson, pull up inside the arc, no good. Rebound ASU. Here comes Emmanuel. Two on two. Emmanuel stops, kicks it outside. Jackson with a three. No, too strong. But a strong rebound for Emmanuel, and what would he have? We got a jump ball, or do we have a foul? I think we're going to call a foul on Southern. Chloe Fleming. She'll be guilty of her first. It's early, but the personal fouls are mounting against Southern. We've already got a player, Sanaya Reed, with two. Six other players have a foul as well. 45 seconds left here in this first quarter as Emmanuel made the first and the second. She has all but three of ASU's points in this first quarter. 12-9. High pick for Fleming. Driving left and running over a defender, no call. Picked up the ball, the shot is good. That is Johnson. And she has 6 points. And it's a 1 point game again. The shot clock is off, 12 seconds to go. Crawford looking for help. Jackson threw it away. And we get a foul at backcourt. Oh, that's tough. Less than a second to go. And that's going to give Southern free throws. I believe that was on Crawford. And that is her second. Oh, my goodness. That is a tough foul. With a half second to go and a free throw, two of them coming. That one does rim out. No good. As the shot is up, they're going to wave it off. They're going to say it's late. They're going to look at it, though. I thought it was late. So they're going to check it out to see if that shot was released before the time expired. We'll take a timeout here at the Acadome right now as we stand. It's 12-11 ASU.
Thank you so much, Dr. O'Neill, for your dedication and service to all of our students.
us on Facebook. For more information on Alabama State women's basketball, follow us on Twitter at Bama State WBB. You can also visit BamaStateSports.com for rosters, bios, stats, and so much
further
more.
Review, that top shot did not count. So chance. That means Alabama State leads as we start the second quarter, 12-11. Southern with the basketball as we begin the second quarter. It's like ASU has moved to a 1-2-2 zone. Or if you want to call it a 3-2 zone, that's okay. Johnson driving, missed the shot. Battle for the board underneath. White's got it, and she'll put it in for her first point. Southern back on top by a point. Underneath, off the glass, good. Ward has her first points of the game. And ASU Seesaw's back on top by a 14-13 score. We've played a minute of the second quarter. ASU stays in the zone. They're posting wide up to the foul line, shot missed by Williams. ASU's in a hurry the other way. Shot is off the glass. No good. Rebound, Southern. Good look by Sanders. Looks like she was kind of in between using the glass and not using the glass on that shot. Johnson driving to her left. Got a high screen. Around into the corner. Williams, jumper, no. What do we got? That'll be a foul on Alabama State, a late whistle. They call it on Ward, and that is her second. We'll see if Coach Freda Freeman Jackson decides to leave her in or pull her here. With two fouls. Looks like the answer is going to be they're going to take her out. So Cordasia Harris will return. Williams shooting a pair. She's just a 44% free throw shooter. As a team, Southern is not very good shooting free throws. 54%. And that's about where they are early on in this one. One for two goes Williams. All three of her points at the foul line. And we're tied at 14. Still near side. Looking for somebody underneath. Instead goes to Sanders. 9 on the shot. Still can't drive. 3. Somebody better put one up, and the shot is no good. Rebound, though, Alabama State. Put back falls for Ryan Tillis. First bucket for Tillis. She only averages 2 a game. A steal on the other end. 3-pointer, though, no good. And we got a foul underneath. May go on Southern. It is. That's Raven White. And that's 2 on their center. First team foul of the quarter. ASU with a 2-point lead with a chance to add to it. Harris off the glass, no good, rimmed out. Rebound Southern. Fleming, left side, 3, no good. Try by McWayne. ASU with a lead in the basketball. Sanders pulls it out. Tries to hand it off to Emmanuel. She's covered. And a walking violation called on Sanders. Harrison returns for Southern. Been nip and tuck pretty much all the way in this first half. Kind of the way this season's been for Alabama State, if you want to know the truth. Hunter, three. No. Rebound tipped. Who hit it last? Southern did. Touched last, I believe, by Mac Metcalf, who's back in the game. ASU will once again try to add to their lead. Again, Ward on the bench with a foul, with two fouls, and there's a foul in backcourt on the Jaguars. That's on Metcalf, and that is her second. And the second team foul of this period for Southern. Loose ball foul away from the basketball. And that goes on Hunter. First on her, third on Southern here in this first period, and they've got about a dozen in the game already. Tillis threw it away. Biggest lead was to start the game, 6 points by Southern. It's been anywhere to 1 to 2 points for either team since. Foul under the basket on the shot. That'll send Johnson to the line.
Second team foul. Two shots. Jeremiah Johnson at the line, shooting two. Substitution into the game of the Hornets, number 24, Samaya Brooks.
Samaya Brooks is going to see some action here. The freshman from Mississippi. Patontic, Mississippi, to be precise. Don't ask me where that is. I don't know. Johnson, the senior at the line, missed the first free throw. The lead is two for Alabama State. Second shot is good. Seven for Johnson in this first half. Moderate pressure by Southern in backcourt, broken by Sanders. Still top of the key, 14 on the shot clock. Sanders looks back to steal. He'll try the three, it's no good. Neither one of these teams having much success shooting from the outside. Most of the points have been underneath. Crawford does have a three-pointer for ASU. In fact, I believe that's the last field goal they scored. Johnson works with a screen, instead kicks it in the corner, and the shot was no good, and I believe Harrison knocks it out of bounds. So ASU will have it length of the floor to take it. Just under 5.5 left in the second period. Steele pulls it out. Tillis back out front, now Sanders. Twelve on the shot. Outside. Driving is steal. Nice bounce pass. And then fouled from behind is Samaya Brooks. Who'll go to the free throw.
Two shots.
So a chance to extend the lead for ASU. Brooks has only been to the free throw line 10 times. She's made 7 of those 10. And thanks to my third grade education, I can tell you that's 70%. The first shot is good. She averages a point a game. She's got that, and she can't make the second. Lead is two now for Alabama State. Johnson to the near side, three is in the air, and the first one made of the day for Southern as McWayne knocks it down. She is their leading three-point shooter. She's got 43 of them so far this year. And Southern back on top. Good pass to the lane, but the shot won't fall. Rebound Southern. Tillis had a good look. And a steal by Steele. Driving and had her shot blocked. Oh, my. McWayne with the block and still almost stole it back. And we need a break, so we're going to take it. 4:08 left to play in the half. 18-17 Southern on top. So far, a one-point game, 18-17. This one not exactly would be very good for instructional video as far as basketball is concerned. Neither team shooting the ball very well. Hornets 26%, 1 of 6 behind the arc, while Southern is 31%, 1 of 8 behind the arc. Both of them with 15 rebounds thus far. Southern. Bounce pass inside, and they find their center, missed the first one, missed the second one, and then has the third one stripped. Emmanuel the other way. And then they throw it away. Going the other way, and a blocking foul will go on on Alabama State, I believe, on Tillis. They're going to call it on Steele, and that's two on her. Ward is already sitting down right now with two fouls. And Johnson is back at the line to shoot a pair. She is 1 of 2 at the free throw line. And she's good on the first. 2-point lead for Southern. Again, they came in with the same identical record as Alabama State, both 6-4 in conference play. Both of them are 9-12 overall. But Southern has lost 2 in a row. Johnson good on 1 out of 2, the rebound controlled by Alabama State. Neither team doing a whole lot from the outside. And Southern has now gone to a zone. Emmanuel tries to kick it inside. It's knocked away from Harris. Sanaya Reed in the ball game for Southern. Ring number 14. And is that going to be a charge? I believe it is.
Offensive
call it on Emmanuel. That is her first. And four team fouls on the Lady Hornets in the second quarter. Alabama State in their five home games had scored 60, make it 70 or more points in every game until Saturday, and there's a shot good and a foul. And I believe that's got to be Johnson getting the two plus the free throw. Deja Harris picking up the foul. Johnson's done the damage for Southern in this first half. But the free throws have been a problem. She can't make that one. She's now two out of five. 21-17, Southern. At least to this point, nobody running away from the other. Emmanuel kicks it into the corner. Three, good. Sanders. Her first points behind the arc. 1 point game. And ASU goes to the zone. That's Hunter will try the three and make it. Hunter has her first field goal. Back to a 4 point lead for the Jaguars. And another pass thrown away. Trying to get it inside. It's tough to pass against the zone. Ball will go back to Southern as the ball knocked away. Brazil Watkins in the ball game for Alabama State, the freshman from Battle Creek, Michigan. A minute 42 to go in the half. Fleming directing traffic. Legions runs over a player. They don't call it, and we get a foul on the shot. Watkins comes in and promptly picks up the foul, her first. Southern is making a living at the free throw line right now. Fortunately for Alabama State, they're not making a very good living, just 6 out of 15. And I jinxed that one, right? Reed making the first of two. She'd only taken four free throws all year. Second shot. No. Rebound tipped once, twice, and we're going to get a rebounding foul on Southern. That should be the fifth team foul on Southern. Legions gets the foul. That is her first.
Foul charge to the Jags, number 22. Two shots.
Way back up, that is her second. And Emmanuel, who is making free throws, which she normally does, an 81% shooter, adds to her total. And does it twice. Got 11 points here in this first half. Good first half for her. She averages 16 a game. A minute 15 to go. First half. McWayne will try the three-pointer, and then the rebound lost out of bounds by Emmanuel. She actually grabbed that rebound off the ground, and it went right off her fingertips. Skip past top of the key. Now outside the arc is Hunter. He'll drive. Leaves it underneath. The shot no good. Putback is short. Rebound, Alabama State. Outlet pass goes to Steele. A lot of blue jerseys back defensively. 52 seconds left to play in the half. Emmanuel has it top of the key. Back to Steele. She'll kick it outside the arc for the three-point shot that's too strong. And I believe we're going to get a three-point, a three free throw attempt for Watkins. Legions picks up the foul. That is her third. And Watkins can tie the game with three free throws. She hasn't been to the line much. She's 4 out of 7 at the line this season. And that one's good. She'll have two more. Right now, even though Alabama State is down, the free throws have kept them in it. Watkins good on the first two. Can she make it three? This one will tie it. Nope, can't do it. Rebound Southern. Southern cannot hold it for a final shot. About a 8 second difference on the clock. Reed, bounce pass. Williams tries to drive, does, off the glass, no. Rebound Alabama State. They got plenty of time, 17 seconds. Let's see if they'll hold it for one shot. Looks like they might. Steele driving, 5 seconds. Sanders, cross court pass, three no good. And that's the way the first half will end. 25-24, our score here at the break. Southern on top in a key SWAC game on the ladies' side. We're going to step aside for a few minutes, take a break. We'll be back for the start of the second half, which will be in about 15 minutes here on the Hornets Sports Network.
we direct your attention center court for a very special presentation. Our very own Office of Events Management, they will be dancing to Cupid Flex. Y'all show them some love. We'll be right back.
Second half about ready to get underway here at Alabama State. The Hornets trailing by a point, 25-24 to visiting Southern. The statistics from that first half, not exactly anything to write home about on either side. In fact, both teams shot the same percentage, although Southern had seven more shots at the goal than did ASU. But they both finished 28%, 28.6 to be precise. Southern hit 2 of 10 three-pointers, 2 of 8 for Alabama State. The free throws, 7 of 17 for the Jaguars, that's 41%. ASU better at 10 of 15 for 67%, 66.66666 to be exact. And the rebounding, ASU with a slight edge there, 22-19. And they will have the basketball to start the second half, and we're underway. ASU working against the man-to-man, and inside they quickly go to somebody who didn't play much in the first half, Samaya Ward. She picked up 2 quick fouls in the first quarter and sat for about 18 of the 20 minutes, maybe not quite that much. Well, they have her for minus 2 minutes. I know that's not possible. So, off the stat. She played roughly about four and a half minutes in that first half, and I think it's going to show up whether or not she makes a difference here in this second half. I have a feeling she will. Crawford is at the line, trying to add to her 3 points, all of those coming on a three-point shot. 1 of 2 made by the Lady Hornets in the first half. Again, both teams enter this game 6-4 in conference play. And ASU is on top after the 2 free throws. Like both teams came back with their original starting 5. Johnson working at the top of the key. And there's a steal by Emmanuel. It's a 3-on-2 break, but Emmanuel will slow it up. ASU will work it, try to get it inside. And they do. Ward spinning, one-hander good. And maybe the difference in this one. If they can continue to do that, Ward, who leads the team in shoot in field goal percentage and in points. Wild shot, and officials are going to get him out of trouble. Well, I can't even get out of my mouth. And Ward picks up her 3rd foul. Wow. So Johnson goes to the line for a pair. Boy, that's tough. I think Ward's going to stay in the game. So she doesn't even play a minute. Well, actually, that's about what she plays. 1 minute in the second half, and she picks up her 3rd foul, but she's going to stay out there. Of course, I'm talking about Ward.
Out of bounds on the play.
Stay with ASU. Inbound thrown away. Didn't get it up high enough. Picked off by McWayne. Inside, shot is good by Johnson. Johnson led the way in the first half for Southern with 10 points. She's added 3 already here, and we've got a timeout taken by Alabama State. Trying to save the turnover and maybe get things back in order here. With a minute, make it 8 minutes, 36 seconds to play in this third quarter. reminder, if you want more information on Alabama State Athletics, you can go to their Twitter account. That's the @BamaStateSports. Also like Bama State on Facebook. For more information on Alabama State women's basketball, follow on Bama State WBB. That's with an @. Also visit BamaStateSports.com for rosters, bios, stats, and much more. Of course, you're listening to us on the internet, watching the game tonight. We'll have another one following this one. The men, Southern, leading the men's conference. Alabama State with a tough break in Saturday's game, losing their top scorer. They'll have a lot to overcome if they're to win and end what is currently a four-game losing streak. But we got this one to finish. What I thought was going to be a 30-second timeout apparently is not, so they used it for the official timeout. Plenty of other action tonight in the conference. We'll get you that schedule here coming up in a little bit. A couple of key games. Including one up in Huntsville with Grambling visiting Alabama A&M. The issue with the basketball. Working against the zone. 14 on the shot clock. Driving, and what do we got? I believe they called a traveling violation on Sanders. Turnovers have been a problem for both of these teams, but particularly for Alabama State. That is 18 now against, actually 19. There's a shot that's dropped, or should say blocked, but then picked up by Fleming, and she puts it in. Fleming has her first field goal. Ward inside, too strong, and we're going to get a foul. That's going to go on Harrison.
Foul charge for the Jays, number 32. Two shots.
Zelise Harrison is a sophomore. And Ward will shoot two. She had one field goal in the first half. It came pretty early because she didn't play due to foul trouble. Carlos Funches across the way was
first warning to the coach of the Jays.
Given a warning, apparently, they don't have a box anymore. They have a coach's line.
Basket is good.
And apparently he crossed it. Ward good on the first. But missed the second, and we got a whistle on the rebound. And it looked like they're going to call it on Southern. Taylor Williams was blocking out Shamaya Ward and picks up a foul. First foul on Williams. The good news for Alabama State, they maintain possession of the basketball with a chance to take the lead. Watkins getting a lot of minutes tonight. She's in the game for Alabama State. Has the basketball on the far side. Emmanuel, who led ASU in scoring in that first half with 11. 2 seconds, one, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Another turnover on ASU. Fleming driving, cut off. Can't get the roll. McQuain has her shot blocked out of bounds by Ward. Don't be surprised if they try to go inside and pick up another foul on Shamaya. Time she kept clear and got the block in the meantime. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Good defense by ASU and a near steal by Emmanuel. Got a hand on it to knock it away. Flipping the inbound. And they have to get it to the tallest player on the court in Harrison. She stands 6'4". That shot no good. But a rebound for Southern. And now what do we have? Whatever it is giving Alabama State the basketball.
Possession points. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, flash photography is strictly prohibited. Again, flash photography is strictly prohibited.
.644 to go, third quarter. Another chance for Alabama State to take the lead. And that ball knocked out of bounds by Southern. Punter in the game for the Jaguars, as is Metcalf. Seven on the shot. Inside, Ward for two. I don't think it's too hard to figure out what Freda Freeman Jackson wants to do in the second half. Get the ball inside to Ward and let her work. And it's so far so good. She's got a couple of buckets here in this third period, and ASU has the lead. Hunter hands off to Johnson driving left, and she ran over Akiah Sanders.
Offensive foul. Charge to the Jags. Number 25, Jeremy Johnson.
There's the first foul on Johnson. And once again, going to be free throw shooting for ASU on the next foul by Southern. As that shot forced, no good by Emmanuel. And then it's out of bounds, touch last by the Jaguars.
Out of bounds on the play, possession Hornets.
From the baseline, Steele dumps it inside. Ward has it knocked away and stolen by Southern. Johnson will launch a three and got it. No, they're saying it's a two. Let me back up. That was Metcalf with her first field goal of the night. Southern back on top by a point. Emmanuel dumps one inside, and the ball knocked away again by Harrison. Southern the other way. And a pass stolen by Alabama State. Emmanuel pushed at midcourt, and they'll get the foul. That'll go on Johnson, I do believe. And we're about to have a media timeout with 4:59 to play, and Alabama State will have free throws when we come back. 32-31, the visiting Jaguars on top. Back with more in a moment.
Thank you.
4:59 to play here at Alabama State. A 32-31 lead for the Jaguars, but Alabama State will have free throws coming back. Ayanna Emanuel will step to the line where she's making a living tonight. And the foul situation getting a little tenuous for Southern. They have three players with three fouls. White, Legions, and Harris all with three. Of course, Ward also has three for Alabama State. That could become, in fact, probably will become a factor here as the second half continues. Emmanuel puts ASU back in front. 33-32. Full court pressure applied by the Hornets and thrown away. There's a turnover. Hornets get the ball back. With 4:55 to go, third period. Trying to add to a one-point lead. Well, turnovers now against Southern as that shot blocked out of bounds by Harrison. Still will inbounds for the Hornets. And the shot no good off the back rim of Crawford. Rebound Southern. Reed. Outside it goes to McWayne. Now Hunter driving, and she took an extra step. That'll give it back to Alabama State. 13 turnovers now on the Jaguars. Both teams acting as though it's Christmas, giving a lot of gifts away this evening. 19 turnovers for Alabama State. Two-three zone applied by Southern. Harris is set up inside for the Hornets. Emmanuel driving and has it blocked, and I think it went off her head, and it did. Five blocks now for Harrison. She came in with 10. Trouble in backcourt, and walk called against Southern. It was going to be a turnover anyway. Steele had stolen the pass. In a way, that's a break for Southern because she had a lane to the goal. And Carlos Funches has seen enough of that. She's going to get a better ball handler in, and Genovia Johnson.
Possession Hornets.
Pass into Emmanuel, tries to spin to the lane, shot no good. Harris gets the rebound, it's blocked. Rebound Southern. Well, the land of the tall timbers, too much right now for Alabama State. 33-32 though, the Hornets lead. Driving is Johnson and she takes a whack. She is not getting up. I believe Emmanuel is guilty. They're going to check and see if this is a flagrant foul on Ayanna Emanuel. So while they check that, the matchups tonight across SWAC basketball, Grambling is at Alabama A&M. Arkansas Pine Bluff is at Jackson State. Florida A&M at Prairie View. Mississippi Valley is visiting Alcorn State, and Bethune-Cookman is in Houston to take on Texas Southern. That game is actually on cable TV tonight. Still waiting on whether or not that was a flagrant.
Thank you.
like it's going to be a common foul. And two shots for Genovia Johnson, who is a 69% free throw shooter. She has been seven times already to the line. She's made four. Excuse me, she's made three. This can tie the game at 33.
One shot.
She'll have one more. She is leading this team in scoring tonight so far. And they're going to wave it off, said she went over the line. So the best she could do is tie the game. Johnson looking down at the line, she said, I didn't think I did that. I would dare say, though, when you're shooting a free throw, you're not looking at where your feet are, right? Tied at 33. Had a couple of those tonight. Six times we've been tied. Emmanuel pull up at the foul line. Wild shot, gets her on rebound. 7 seconds, it didn't reset the clock. And Southern gets it back, another turnover. Into the corner, Hunter, yes.
3 points.
That's her second three of the day. And it gives Southern the lead. ASU continuing to try to pound the ball inside. Emmanuel. Now on the left side it goes to Crawford. Back to Emmanuel. Three in the way. No good. Too strong. Battle for the board. Harris goes to the floor along with the Southern player. And the Jaguars come up with it. 2:27 to go, third quarter. Well, the Jaguars a little slow getting back. I believe that is Johnson. Hunter needs help. 1 second on the shot clock. They won't get it off. Shot clock violation gives it back to Alabama State. Kaya Sanders in the game for the Hornets. She'll work at point guard with a minute 54 to play in this third period. 3-point advantage for Southern. They've stayed in that zone. It's worked a good bit, especially with Ward on the bench. Steele dumps it inside. Harris goes in, has another shot blocked. I believe that's six for Harrison. Wraparound pass thrown away. Sanders needs some help. Sets it up inside. Here we go again. Harris inside. This time she'll kiss it off the glass for her first field goal of the night. 36-35. If at first you don't succeed, try. I think I need to say try about five times again. As ASU, despite all the blocked shots underneath, this time they'll try to get a shot themselves underneath with Southern, and it will draw a foul. And I think they're going to get it on Harris. And that is her fourth, according to my numbers. And let's see here. Yep, that is four on Cordasia Harris. So she'll have to leave. We'll see Ryan Tillis replace her. Taylor Williams in for Southern. Meanwhile, at the line is Genovia Johnson. three of seven at the line. Clanks off the back rim. She'll have another try. It's a freebie, but she'll make it. Still, it stepped into the lane early, but it didn't matter. 2-point lead for Southern. Into the corner, three in the air. It's too strong, air ball. Rebound, and that's going to be a tie-up, and that'll still stay with Southern. Position. 34 seconds left to play in the third. There's about a 4.5 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. So for all intents and purposes, Southern can hold for the last shot. Metcalf dribbling out the time near midcourt. Eight on the shot clock. Pull up. Nice dump inside, but they missed the shot. 6 seconds left. Watkins, three on the way. No good. Nice try by Nikaya Sanders. And we have played three quarters. 2-point game. 37-35, Southern over Alabama State. We'll be back with more here at the Acadome in a moment. Back with you here at the John Oliver Acadome. We've got one quarter at least to go. 37-35. Southern on top. ASU will start with the basketball as we get back to action.
Possession Hornets.
Sanders handles it out front. Emmanuel skips a pass, nearly over the reach of Tillis. She gets it, though. Now she's in the corner, Emmanuel is. Again, stiff zone defense. Ward is back in for Alabama State. Shot good, counted in the foul. Ayana Emmanuel with a big bucket there. Chance for a three-point play. I'm required to say the old-fashioned way, I think. She'll have to make the free throw, which she's done mostly tonight. But that one too strong. Rebound, Southern. We're tied, 37 apiece. They are double-teaming. Whoever's underneath, that ball is lost out of bounds, and it was touched last by Southern. Right now, it's Raven White underneath for Southern. Ward fronted her. And she also got some help from Emmanuel. LSU can take the lead. Crawford, Tillis inside, skip pass. Now they get it top of the key. Three, no. What do we got? Rebounding foul. It's going to go on Southern. Might be on Raven White. Since you cleared out. Actually, they're going to call it on Taylor Williams. So the ball back to Southern. Excuse me, to Alabama State, and Emmanuel can't handle the inbounds pass. Tough break there. Fleming around the horn. Cross court pass, dangerous one to Johnson. And now in the corner it goes, and the three is no good. Rebound Alabama State. Sanders getting dogged in back court by Williams. And Emmanuel traveled. Yeah, she lost control. Put it on her hip and took an extra step. And she's going to sit down in favor of Samaya Steele. 8:19 left to go in this one. Fleming with McWayne. Dump inside, White, spinning, shot, no. Rebound offensive, block. And out of bounds it goes against ASU. They lost it. Southern will keep it on their end of the floor. Shot clock did reset. I think we got a timeout taken by Southern. Carlos Funches calling the timeout. It is a 30-second timeout. Again, the men's game will follow this one about 30 minutes after. As Alabama State's men's team will try to end a four-game losing streak. And then the teams hit the road for the next two. They'll be at Florida A&M on Saturday. And it's very tight, both sides of the league, when I say that, men and women's side. Jackson State currently leads the women's standings. They are 9-1 in conference play. Alabama A&M and Bethune-Cookman two games back at 7-3. And then you've got four teams, including these two, tied for fourth with a 6-4 record. So you can see why this game means a lot tonight. I believe these two teams will play again. Let me check that. Verify that here in just a minute. Meantime, Jaguar basketball under their own goal. With just under 8 minutes to play in this final period. Tied at 37. Johnson against the 2-3 ASU zone. That's Fleming with it now. Gives it off and gets a return from Williams. Shot no good. Ward, battle for it. Comes down to Fleming. Let me make that Williams. And she makes the shot and picks up the foul. Sanders picking up the foul.
Taylor Williams at the line, shooting one.
And
Official review.
And apparently they're going to review something on this foul. That was the first foul of the game on Kaya Sanders. I don't know if they're looking at something that may have been in the facial area or not, but we got to verify. I was mentioning the schedule for Alabama State. And I believe I told you wrong where they're going next. They're actually going to Arkansas Pine Bluff over the week, and they'll play there on Saturday, and then they're at Mississippi Valley on Monday. And yes, these two teams will meet again Thursday, March the 2nd. That will be down in Baton Rouge. In fact, ASU finishes the regular season on the road before Southwestern Athletic Conference tournament play starts on March the 8th. The championship game slated for March the 11th. That will be in Birmingham. Well, the powwow continues here. Like it's going to be a common foul. And Crawford is at the line to shoot one after the made field goal to give Southern the lead. It will be one shot. No good. Rebound Ward. 2-point game. Ward has it top of the key and throws it away. Another turnover. Williams the other way. Layup missed. And ends up into the hands of Tillis. Skip pass comes to steal. Crawford dumps it to the baseline. Shot no good by Tillis. Ball tipped around. Looked like it might have been Tillis knocking it away from her teammate. Here comes Southern the other way. Clock is not a factor, not yet. 6:50 to play. Watson thought about a three and decided against it. Nine on the shot. Now looking to drive, gets a pick, leaves it outside for Williams. She has it knocked away. Two on the shot clock. Did they get it off? Well, it doesn't matter. That one sailed out of here. That one had wings on it. Back to Alabama State. Turnovers again, becoming a problem. This has been a problem all day for both of these teams. 19 turnovers against Southern, 23 by Alabama State. All the way across it comes to Crawford. She finds Ward underneath, and she's got the shot off the glass. That's been a winning ticket so far for Alabama State, and we're tied at 39. 7 points now for Shamaya Ward, well under her average of 14 a game. But she has been in foul trouble. There's a walk underneath. Give it back to Alabama State. Thought for a second they may call a foul. White did shuffle her feet. And another turnover gives Alabama State a chance to take the lead. Sanders out front. Now to steal. In no hurry. Working clock. Steal. Throws it away. Tried to throw it in the middle of his own. Didn't work. Fleming has it far side. Inching close to 5 minutes to play in this one. Like this is all Alabama State has known this season. And we got a foul underneath. It may go against Alabama State. They're going to call that on Steele, I believe.
Foul charge on the Hornets, number 11, Samaya Steele.
Three fouls on her.
Possession chance.
Two team fouls on the Hornets. 5:02 to play. Oh, thrown off the leg of McQuain. And I believe a timeout taken quickly by the Southern bench. That was going to set up to be a chance for a double team in the corner. Not good news. And Southern wisely gets the timeout. It comes with 4:59 to go in regulation. It is a 30-second timeout. I can't even call this a game of runs, to be honest. Neither team has been able to get on one. The closest thing to a run was early on when Southern scored the first 6 points of the game. They actually have led by as many as eight. That was also early. But since then, neither team has been able to shake the other. ASU's largest lead has been 3 points. We're under five to go. Fleming. Johnson driving left side. Shot no. Rebound is lost. Picked up by Alabama State. Manuel nearly turned it over. Sanders with it. Now over to Steele. Southern has gone back to man-to-man defense. Here comes the three from Sanders. Yes, sir. She had one in the first half. She's got her first here in the second. And the Lady Hornets on top by three. 4 minutes to go. Working against the zone. Driving baseline, no good on the shot, and a foul on the rebound. It'll go against Hunter. Two on Hunter, three on Southern in the fourth quarter. Tillis will leave in favor of Crawford. And we've got a timeout on the court. Alabama State, which hasn't enjoyed many leads tonight, but they've got one right now, 42-39. We'll be back. ASU with the basketball, leading it by three. 3:49 left in this very important conference game between the Hornets and Southern. ASU with the basketball. Been working against the zone most of the night. Right now it's a man-to-man. Crawford to steal, four on the shot clock. missed the shot. Rebound, long one back to ASU. Underneath, pass knocked away, and it was touched last by Alabama State. I'm not so sure that ball gone out of bounds. Sanders might have let it go, and it would have stayed with the Hornets, but that's not the case. She tried to save it. So Southern has it. Tillis is back. Steele sits down. Crowd on hand here at the Acadome tonight. Fleming taking her time, under 3 minutes to play. Johnson to Diamond Hunter, and she gets a kind roll for a three. And we're tied again. 9 points for Hunter, all of them behind the arc. Tillis looking inside. There's Emmanuel. Thought about pulling up at the foul line. Now Tillis will try a three, no good. And Raven White clears. Jump ball, but that'll give it back to Southern. Emmanuel took a tumble. Looks like she's all right, as is Raven White. At this point, every possession is going to be important. And we're tied at 42. 2:20 left. Johnson has it up top. She'll drive to her right and throws it up. They call traveling. Good call. She was out of control. And another turnover. That's 22 now against Southern. So the Hornets, another chance to take the lead, and I believe the Alabama State bitch wants a timeout. 2 minutes, 2:01 to be exact. It's going to be a full timeout. Why don't we take it as well on the Hornet Sports Network?
Hornet Nation, are you ready for the greatest competition around? Well, the Alabama State University will host the 2023 Mondo Battle of the Bands Invitational Showcase on February 18th, featuring none other than our Mighty Marching Hornets. Get your tickets today at www.mondobattleofthebands.com. We'll see you there.
Finished my thought a couple of minutes ago. It seems as though Alabama State, the women anyway, can't finish a game without it going down to the wire. And that's what we're set up for here with under 2 minutes to play in a tie game. Sanders needs help. And a quick timeout, maybe a little too quick for Alabama State. To save the turnover, it is a 30-second timeout. But just to give you an idea of what these Lady Hornets have done, on their home schedule again. They had scored. Or more points in every game up until Saturday. And they're going to have to really go some to get to 50 tonight. They lost to Grambling 52-51. So here we go. There's seven on the shot clock. Driving, pull up. Do we get a foul? Right as the horn sounded. And it is a foul on Southern. So that pulls Crawford out of the fire, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. And as we mentioned, free throw shooting going to be big the rest of the way. And if there is one advantage Alabama State has, it is their free throw shooting. They shoot better than 70% as a team. Two big ones here for Crawford. She's made both tries tonight. That one too strong. Another chance to give ASU the lead. 1:36 left to play in this one. That one hits the bottom of the bag. And a 43-42 game. Raven White staying in the game for Southern. She comes to set the high pick. Looks like ASU staying in that zone, and that's to try to save any problems for Ward. 10 on the shot clock. Long three, no good. Rebound run down, though, by Southern. That ball barely drew the rim, but a break for Southern. Under a minute to play. Seven on the shot. McWayne nearly throws it away. Fleming, will she get the shot off? She did. Rebound. And what do we got? They're going to call a jump ball, and that should give it to Alabama State. Discussion between the officials. And I'm sorry, I'm blocked by the third official. I can't see what they're doing. One may have called a foul. Another one may have called jump ball. There's 47 seconds on the clock. The ASU fans want a jump ball, and they're going to get it. Big call goes their way. And I'm sorry, I really didn't see what happened there. I was blocked by an official. I don't care. The ASU's got it. Full court pressure will be applied by Southern. Southern does not have to foul. They will get another possession. Hopefully it's after a Hornets basket. 19 on the shot, 34 on the game clock. Emmanuel, top of the key. Three-pointer up and good! Big shot by Emmanuel. Gives ASU a four-point lead with 24 seconds left. I think they're going to verify the clock. There's no doubt she was behind the arc. Say the clock is good, I do believe. Two possession game now with 24 seconds left. Huge shot by Ayana Emmanuel, the senior out of Fort Lauderdale Dillard High School. She came in averaging 16 points. And she's got 18 in this one. If you're Alabama State, you do not want to foul. Not a lot of time for Southern to pass it around. Johnson driving, pull up at the elbow, no, rebound knocked away, out of bounds by Alabama State. No shot clock now, as if it matters for Southern. 15 seconds left. They'll probably try to get it to White. Instead, Johnson. And a blocking foul on Alabama State. That's a break for Southern. Emmanuel picks up the foul. And it's her third foul. If by some chance we go to an extra period, that could loom large. The good news for Alabama State, and that shot missed by Johnson, and she said, they're blowing the horn while I'm taking the free throw. The official, Marcus Smart, says, I don't care, it doesn't count. One shot. I don't think they did it on purpose, he said with a wink. This will make it a one possession game. She made it. So Johnson at the free throw line makes it a three-point game. 4 of 9 at the stripe. What did I tell you about free throws? 46-43, full court pressure. Emmanuel triple teamed in backcourt. And they're going to get a foul on Southern. Johnson picks up her third. 12 seconds on the shot, on the clock. Tillis will come into the game, replacing Steele. And Emmanuel will shoot two free throws. A three-point lead for the Hornets. Emmanuel is 9 of 11 at the stripe, which is right at her average of 81%. Perfect. 19 points for Ayanna Emmanuel. This will make it a 5-point lead, and she does it. 20 for the senior from Fort Lauderdale. And we got a timeout taken by Southern. And they will take possession when we come back at midcourt. Why don't we take a quick one? Timeout on the floor. ASU leading it by 5. We'll be back. Alabama State. We'll try to knock these last 12 seconds, 12.7 to be exact, off the clock. We've got a 5-point lead. Southern does have the basketball. I do not have their timeouts. I want to say they may have one left. Metcalf out front. They're running out of time. 6 seconds. Fires an air ball. It'll go back to Alabama State. And unless they've got some magic in their pocket, Southern's going to get out of here with a loss. They are not going to foul. The clock's going to run out. And the Lady Hornets are going to take a 48-43. We'll call it a come-from-behind victory over Southern. So the Lady Hornets continue winning close games. They do it again in this one to improve their record to 10-12 and 7-4 in conference play. Meanwhile, the Lady Jaguars fall to 9-13 and 6-5. These two teams will meet again later on this season in early March. The key, Ayanna Emanuel, a big three-point shot late. She also added two free throws. She finished with the 20 points and is the only player in double figures for Alabama State. Meanwhile, the Southern Jaguars, led by Genovia Johnson, with 14 points. Only two players tonight in double figures. That's going to do it for the women's game. But hang around. We got the men's game coming up. We'll start that one in about 30 minutes or so right here on the Hornet Sports Network. We'll talk to you then.